On behalf of Student Orchestras of Greater Olympia, welcome to our winter concert. Before we start, please look around and find the nearest exit to use in case of an emergency, keeping in mind it may not be the door you came in. We encourage the use of cell phones to access today's program, but please keep them in silent mode and use them discreetly to avoid distracting those around you. And finally, please join us in expressing appreciation to Olympia Federal Savings for generously sponsoring today's concert. Yay, OlyFed!
Thank you. Okay, thank you very much, and good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the March SOGO concert. So excited to see so many of you here. So that was the first ever performance of that piece. That was the children's concert overture by local Olympia-based composer James DeHart. And whenever you have a world premiere and the composer is here, we like to have them run out onto the stage. So please show your appreciation to James DeHart.
Thank you.
Hi there, I'm Milt Harper, and it's my honor to serve as the board president for SOGO. And that's kind of irresistible, isn't it? You've probably noticed there are a few more students on our stage than there was last year. And they showed on the graphic earlier, we have 138 students in SOGO now. Is that right? And we're not stopping there. We are continuing to grow, and I haven't told people this, but I have a goal of growing so many more students that we have to add another orchestra. But we'll keep working on that. But the thing about that growth is that, along with that, is there's a need for us to increase our scholarship fund as well. And our board has established a goal to raise $15,000 for our scholarship fund this spring, and we're going to be sending out some information about that real soon, but you don't have to wait for that information. There's something you can do today that will help, and it has to do with this. We are going to have these out in the lobby after the concert, and for a small donation, you will be able to fulfill your dream of getting to squeeze the taxi horn bulb. And I assure you that after you hear An American in Paris, which is the first number in the second half, that urge is just going to be absolutely irresistible. So I hope to hear you squeezing the bulb horn a little bit later. And in the meantime, the Academy Orchestra is coming on, and I'll get out of your way. So thank you.
It may have been quite some time since many of you were enrolled in elementary school or middle school. But please take a moment to engage your imagination. Presto! You are now in your favorite possibly slightly stinky, school gymnasium, awaiting the SOGO Academy Orchestra presentation at your school. Shh! The program is about to begin.
We began today's program with the ending of our first piece, Grand March by Richard Wagner. My name is Quinn, and I play violin in the SOGO Academy Orchestra that is before you. The Academy Orchestra, conducted by Mr. Greg Allison, is the middle-level group of our three SOGO orchestras. It is difficult to imagine, but there was a time when television, movies, and video games did not exist. A very popular form of entertainment for those who were near more prominent cities in the 18th and 19th centuries was opera.
You've got to be kidding.
Nope. Grand March occurs in an opera titled Tangos that features a singing contest, kind of like America's Got Talent, without confetti. The main theme, or melody, listen carefully, there will be a quiz later, is played as the audience and contestants file into a large auditorium. You can sense the movement as the melody was played. True? Music helps to set the scene and moves the story along. Count how many times that same melody is played in the march. There will be a quiz at the end. Now please enjoy Grand March by Wagner.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I am Isabel, and I play the violin. So, how many times was the same melody played in Grand March by Wagner? Raise your hand when you think I give the correct answer. Once? Twice? Three times? Four? Five? Six? More than six times?
Some of you didn't vote.
Well, drum roll, please. Actually, the exact melody was only played twice, although there were slight... There were slight variations of the melody played multiple times. Good work on your listening. Music can usually be divided into two categories, psalm and dance. We now present a dance for you, the tango. The tango is a dance that has influences from African and European cultures. It has been said that it takes two to tango, and we have two times two from Ballet Northwest, and our dancers are Elliot, Gibson, Penelope, and Audrey, who will dance two slightly different versions of the tango. The first is El Choclo, and the second is La Comparsita. Both are traditional South American tangos arranged by Merle Isaac. Please give a big welcome to our tango dancers.
Thank you.
We had an amazing time on our tour. The most amazing part was our middle school canceled the day of. And because we had had a great relationship with another school district through our SOGO to Schools program, they not only provided us a place to play just for a few people, but they actually, at Montesano, put on a full school assembly for us that day. Is that amazing? Yeah. We actually didn't do that one for the assembly, the one that we just played. That was just for today. But this last one that we're going to play for you, we did. But if our country or our world has any hope, these are it. They're great kids.
So, this next project is a little different. Earlier this year, we were approached by Ballet Northwest, same Ballet Northwest from whence came the tango dancers you saw earlier. Yeah, you can clap for them. They did a great job. They approached us and asked if we wanted to do An American in Paris for the Olympia Dance Festival, which was last night. And there's this arrangement for 17-ish players, and we thought this would be a great opportunity for the teaching artists. Now, the teaching artists who work with your students put in countless hours leading sectionals and offering comments and playing with each of the orchestras in the back of the section, but they never get a chance to show off. So, this is that opportunity. So we played last night down in the pit with a very exciting choreography of dancers on stage. And unfortunately, we don't have dancers today for this, but we wanted to present this for you to enjoy seeing the folks that work with your students every week. So this is the teaching artists doing an arrangement of, well, it's just a reorchestration. It's not any easier. In fact, it's actually harder than the original because they're trying to cover a full orchestra's worth of parts with 17 players. But a chamber orchestra version of An American in Paris.
Thank you.
But wait, we still have 18 more minutes of music. So one more thing about that. Now you've enjoyed the taxi horns in context. I want to give a public thank you to Randy Grostick, who's the band and orchestra teacher at Reeves Middle School, for we got the horns and they were just by themselves. So he built us a stand and a mount, and then also a friend of Mr. Allison's contributed to that as well. So by the goodness of their hearts, thank you very much.